Hello everyone, let's go for a walk. No wonder I don't go outside. Nope. Oh, this ain't half bad. Never mind. Well, at least it wasn't a human.
This time?
Huh? How the hell are they everywhere? Oh, you don't think so? See? Would I lie? Never. Anyway, their commonness does not mean they're boring, though. Far from it. They're actually rather impressive. When you're willing to look past the... whatever. Look at these eyes. They're really cool. Oh, sorry. They're a lot better than your puny peepers. We humans only have three kinds of color receptors in our eyes, called cones. Pigeons are pentachromatic, which means they have five. Relative to their size, their eyes are massive. Probably to fit all the cones up in there. Oh yeah, and the neat little proteins that allow them to see the Earth's magnetic field. Before you get too jealous and throw your eyes out. I'll mention that they can't move their eyes. They're fixed in place. We humans can move our eyes, which helps us stabilize our vision when we move about. Most birds can't do that. That's why they bob their heads when they walk. So yeah, you win some, you lose some. Imagine if we had to do this as well. Hey Tim, hey Tom. There have been attempts to utilize their eyes to our benefit. In 1976, scientists began training pigeons to spot people lost at sea from a little observation chamber strapped at the bottom of a search and rescue helicopter. From there, they could alert the pilots by pecking a button if they spotted anyone or anything. And it worked rather well. They even saw real action in a search and rescue mission in 1979. But it didn't end well for them, because the helicopter had to do an emergency landing. And during that mess, the observation chamber was torn from the helicopter and lost. Including the pigeons, of course. So it goes. This project was not the only or even the first time we tried to use pigeons and their pecking action to our advantage. During the Second World War, scientists tried to create a pigeon-guided bomb. The pigeon was put into the tip of the bomb, where there was a screen that was hooked up to the bomb steering mechanism. It also had the target on it. If the pigeon pecked right, the bomb turned right. If the pigeon pecked up, the bomb pitched up. You get the idea. Just fill it up with explosives, and now you're the proud owner of a pigeon-guided bomb. Congratulations. when the bomb was released. The pigeon just pecked and pecked and pecked at the screen until... Yeah. I will mention that this system never got tested outside the lab because it was cancelled in 1944, because the military didn't take it that seriously. I don't know, maybe they were interested in dog catapults. Or they just didn't want all that delicious pigeon milk to go to waste. Yep, it's called pigeon milk or crop milk, and it has about as much in common with mammalian milk as I have with a pigeon itself. Okay, bad example, never mind. This nutritious, but probably not delicious, cheese curd-like substance is produced in the crops of both female and male birds. Only a few species produce crop milk, though. That list includes all pigeons and doves, flamingos, and male emperor penguins. They use it to feed their young, just like we mammals do. So I don't know, maybe next time you look at a pigeon, you might see something more than a rat with wings. Nope. I guess that's all. For now. Ooh, ominous. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.